getting prepared, church, for that marriage with the Lord, the marriage supper of the Lamb. Because we're the bride of Christ. We're the bride of Christ from the Church Without Judgment. I'm your host, your brother Mark Connor. We're gonna have shop talk and worship. The Lord told me to implement some shop talk with a little worship. And then we're gonna look at Amos, the shepherd, the minor prophet. We're gonna talk about a whole bunch of things. We're gonna have some prayer, we're gonna have some worship. We might sing, we might dance. We're gonna do the fivefold ministry of the gospel. Because the kingdom of God is not just eating and drinking, but it is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. Mm-hmm. And if you think you're religious, first of all, we have a relationship, not religion. But the Bible tells us true and undefiled religion is looking after the widows and taking care of the orphan and keeping oneself unspotted from the world, because the world will give you spots like a leopard. Amos, the title burden, he's a burden bearer, or bearing a load. That's what we're going to do today. Some of us are weak. We're the book of judgment, the book of punishment. Amen. This book was written around Amos' ministry, covered about a period of about 10 years, from 765 to 755 BC. 765 years before Christ, during the reign of Jeroboam the second of Israel. Amen. I'm going to give you the purpose. One, to pronounce judgment upon the Gentile nation. To pronounce punishment upon the Gentile nations for their transgressions. Oh, Lord. I'm going to give you another one. To pronounce punishment upon Israel, the chosen nation, for their transgression. And then the third one, to proclaim promises of restoration in the messianic times that we're in now. We're in the season of the Lord. We're in the latter day wine. He's coming back soon. Amen. We're having shop talk and worship. So we're going to look in here. Christ is seen as the burden bearer, not only bearing our sins, Isaiah 53:12, but also the burdens of the word of the Lord, John 1:1-2. He is the final judge and the punisher of all nations, 2 Thessalonians 1:7-9. And he is the builder of the church, Matthew 16:18-19. I think that's when Peter and him were in discourse. The spiritual tabernacle of David. We're going to look in here right now. Amen. Amen. I hope you guys are doing well. I'm your brother Mark Connor. If you've never been here before, I'm asking that you subscribe to my channel, to my station. This is where we give you the word of God and we have worship. Prophecy will come in here. What comes in is whatever the kingdom is doing. Like I said, the kingdom of God is not just eating and drinking, but it is righteousness. How? In peace. We have peace and liberty to enjoy this fruit. And then there's fruit of the Spirit. I want to look in here. I'm going into Amos chapter 3. Amen. I'm going into Amos chapter 3. I thought I was going to take a nap, but I want to talk about Israel right now for a minute. The prophecy has been set. There'll probably be a peace treaty later, but it will be broken into pieces, just like they're breaking the bones and the blood is being poured out. They're being martyred on all sides. Gaza, Gaza Strip, Palestine up north, Israel south. Now they're running them over there to Egypt, and Egypt don't want them. I gotta watch what I say. Egypt is upset because of what took place years ago. So the stage is set for Armageddon. Amen. I'm in Amos chapter 3. We're having shop talk and worship. Let's worship him in spirit and in truth. We're going to worship him and in spirit and in truth. I got the volume right where I need it for this, because Psalms 150 says, let all the earth praise and worship him. There's a sound that's going on right now. There's a sound in the trumpet. The trumpet is blowing. There's a sound all over the world right now. People are talking about a sound that's coming from the earth. But I want to talk to us. I gave you a backdrop of Amos. He's a minor prophet. And I want to talk about this sound. We're going to pray in a little bit. You guys can put in the comments your prayer request. You should have some needs. I'll pray for you in confidentiality, and I won't tell anybody about it. Amos chapter 3. I want to start at verse 6. If a trumpet is blown in a city, I told you there's a sound, will not the people be afraid? If there is calamity in a city, will not the Lord have done it? You think man has calamity, and man, we can be immoral and different things, but God, he's a God of war, and he's a God of love. He's been watching some things on his altar, on his throne. And he says, I'm observing and I haven't moved yet. If a trumpet is blown in the city, will not the people be afraid? They're afraid right now in Israel. If there's calamity in a city, will not the Lord have done it? Verse 7. Surely the Lord God does nothing. Listen to this. Surely the Lord God does nothing unless he reveals his secrets to his servants, the prophets. A lion has roared. That trumpet, did you hear it? 8. A lion has roared. Who will not fear? The Lord God has spoken. Who can but prophesy? Proclaim in the palace at Ashdod or Assyria, and in the palaces in the land of Egypt. Listen to this. We're in war all over the world, and this is why. It's always going to be from the Middle East. And say assemblies on the mountains of Samaria. This is thousands of years ago. This is, remember, about 865 years to 75 before Jesus. Before Jesus, this is the report. See great tumult in her midst, or chaos. And the oppressor, or the oppressor within her, 10. For they do not know to do right. This is why we're in war. This is why if you're having issues, this, I'm not saying we will all, even though you're in the remnant, it's not going to be perfect because we're in an imperfect world. But I'm here to speak to you. I want to show you something. In 9, proclaim in the palace at Ashdod and in the palaces in the land of Egypt, and say assemblies on the mountain of Samaria. I'm going somewhere. See great tumults or chaos in her midst and the oppression within her. This is why. This is why we get in a net. For they do not know to do right, says the Lord. This ain't me. Who stores up violence and robbery in their palaces. Therefore, thus says the Lord God, an adversary shall be all around the land. Is this not going on right now in the United States too? An adversary. There are sales of evil right now in America. California, Michigan, and Virginia, Michigan. They're cell groups just like they're doing over there, but they're pocketed right here. That's why the borders are open. Therefore, thus said the Lord God, an adversary shall be all around the land. We're cornered in. He shall sap your strength from you. If you've been tired, Satan is at the door. And your palaces shall be plundered, says the Lord. The Lord says, thus says the Lord, as a shepherd takes from the mouth of a lion two legs or a piece of an ear, so shall the children of Israel be taken out who dwell in Samaria in the corner of a bed and on the edge of a couch. CNN is showing Hezbollah and them, they've killed the parents, and then the enemy is holding Rachel's children, and them kids are crying in the corner of a bed and on the edge of a couch. Hear and testify against the house of Jacob. Hear and testify against the house of Jacob, says the Lord God, the God of hosts. I gotta get some water. Praise God. Satan trying to come in on me. He's trying to close up my throat. Pray for me right now. He's trying to close up my throat chakra just shut. I knew when we were gonna have this service, the enemy, he is setting up reserve camps. God is speaking. The enemy is setting up reserve camps. That's why these services are going to be coming more quickly, because we have to come up against the enemy like David. Thus saith the Lord God, as a shepherd takes from the mouth of a lion two legs or a piece of an ear, so shall the children of Israel be taken out who dwell in Samaria, in the corner of a bed and on the edge of a couch. Thank you, Holy Ghost. I'm feeling better. Pray for me, y'all. Hear and testify. They're coming against us prophets. Hear and testify against the house of Jacob, says the Lord God, the God of hosts, that in the day I punish Israel for their transgressions. Remember this, Gentiles too. I will also visit destruction on the altars of Bethel, and the horns of the altar shall be cut off and fall to the ground. The altar where the priest is supposed to be ministering. I will destroy the winter house along with the summer house. We got that down here in Arizona. They come up from back east around now because it's getting cooler. But God says the summer and the winter are going to be destroyed. The houses of ivory shall perish, and the great houses shall have an end, says the Lord. And it's because in 10, for they do not know to do right, says the Lord, who store up violence and robbery in their palaces. or devastation. There's devastation in Israel right now. There's coming devastation in this nation in a minute. But I'm going to share something to you if we repent. Israel will be sifted, but God says a few of us, including the Gentiles, if we repent, means call on the name of the Lord and you will be saved. A few will be grafted, mean put back in to the holy tree. The olive tree of the Lord in the book of Romans. Some will be grafted in, not many, but some. Because the messianic Jesus is here. I'm getting ready to read it. Amos 9. And then I'm going to pray and worship. Amos 9:8. Behold, that means look. The eyes of the Lord God are on the sinful kingdom. And I will... Behold, the eyes of the Lord God are on the sinful kingdom or nations, and I will destroy it from the face of the earth. Yes, yet I will not utterly destroy the house of Jacob. Yet I will not utterly destroy the house of Jacob, says the Lord. That means whatever is going to happen over there, he's coming back to deal with the armies, but it won't be destroyed. Are they dying? Yes, they're being martyred. For surely I will command, 9, I will sift the houses of Israel among all nations as grain is sifted in a sleet. Yet not the smallest grain shall fall to the ground. All the sinners of my people shall die by the sword. Who says the calamity shall not overtake nor confront us? You hear all that? This is for all the prideful people. All the sinners of my people shall die by the sword. And who say the calamity shall not overtake us or confront us? It's the prophecy. On that day I will raise up. On that day I will raise up the tabernacle of David, which has fallen down, and repair its damages. It's getting ready to happen. I will raise up its ruin and rebuild it as in the days of old, that they may possess the remnant of Edom, O Lord. And all they dealt with Joseph, and all the Gentiles who are called by my name, says the Lord who does this thing. Behold, or look, the days are coming, says the Lord, when the plowman shall overtake the reaper and the treader of grapes him who sows seed. The mountain shall drip with sweet wine, and all the hills shall flow with it. I will bring back the captives of my people Israel. Ah, they shall build the waste cities and inhabit them. They shall plant vineyards and drink wine from them. They shall also make gardens and eat fruit from them, the Garden of Eden, the new heaven and the new earth. I will plant them in their land. I will plant them in their land. You ready to get planted? And no longer shall they be pulled up from the land I have given them. Ah, I will plant them in their land, and no longer shall they pull up from the land I have given them, says the Lord your God. Abba, hey. I praise God right now. I gotta look at something else. Listen to this music real quick. The marriage of the Lamb is coming. I love you, Lord. There's gonna be a marriage supper of the Lamb. We are going to be put in a place of perfection. Wow. The new kingdom, the new Jerusalem, that will spring up out of the water, out of his spirit. The new Jerusalem I'm hearing. I'm hearing the new Jerusalem. I'm asking that you pray right now. I'm going to close with this. Revelations 21. Now I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away. Also, there was no more sea. Then I, John, 21 verse 2, Revelation. Then I, John the Revelator, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, coming down, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from heaven saying, behold, or look, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. God himself will be with them and be their God. Listen to this. 4. And God will wipe away. He's doing this right now. If you hear this, listen to this right now. This is powerful. You may be crying and you may be delayed while we're on this earth. But in God, and 4, God will wipe away every tear from their eye. There shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away. Behold, he's making everything new. Then he who sat on the throne said, behold, I make all things new. And he said to me, write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said to me, it is done. I am the Omega, the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give of the fountain of water of life. Do you want life? He has living water freely to him who thirsts. He who overcomes shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my sons. He shall be my sons, because he is the Alpha and the Omega. I'm speaking right now because the word of God is so fresh. Father, right now I bless you because we went in there and we saw you were going to be adorned. He's telling us to get the oil prepared and get ready. Put on the robe of righteousness. Get on, robe on, and the ring, the signet ring, he's putting it on you right now. He's going to have a festival for you. It's a marriage. Come on in. He's got the wine in the vat. He's in the wine press right now. God says he's in the wine press because he can be anywhere at the same time. He is omnipresent and he's present in your life. God says right now he's destroyed the yoke. The yoke is going to be removed. Over there in Israel, we saw that we'll be grafted, a few of us. But what you got to do is, what is this? You just got to cry out and say, save me, Lord. Because whosoever believes in him shall have everlasting life. But in Revelations and Romans, it tells us about the story in Romans 1 that we're without excuse because of what he has made. He has made everything by his word. He created it and he just thought about it. He said, I may do it. I don't know who is before the Lord. I don't think it was Methuselah, but it wasn't no one. There was no one there in the valley of decision when he did it. Father, right now, I bless you right now. now with the power of God. He told us and he says he does nothing until he reveals it to the prophet. And he's saying this. He has fruit for you and we can do it. Just get under the showers. In this latter day rain, he's showering some and some will be destroyed. But I need you to understand, he will put you in his strong tower where the righteous run in and they are safe. We must look at Amos. Amos was just a young boy and God endowed him with the Holy Ghost. Just like Joseph, he was out there dealing and dirty, and then God just laid a cloak on him. He laid a cloak of thanksgiving. He laid a cloak of harvest. He laid the anointing on him. And when the anointing comes on you, it launches you out of a natural ability, and then you're able to speak the word of truth. You're able to speak the word of truth. And what I'm hearing right now, there's getting ready to be a deliverance. There's getting ready to be a deliverance for God's people like never did before. It's not just going to happen in Israel. It's going to happen all over the world. They have the cell groups right now and they're terrorists, but God says they're under our feet. Father God, right now I bless you and I thank you, give you a thanksgiving, because Amos, he taught us that in 10 and 3:10, it talked about we did not want to become righteous. So then you spit us out. You spit us out like in Revelation. Oh, you got the books. Oh, the churches. There were many churches, but he spit the one out. And I think it was in Thyatira. But don't do it to me like that, meaning I could be wrong, but it was one of those. He said in his word in Revelation, he said, I would rather you be hot nor cold, but since you're neither hot nor cold, he says, I'm going to spit you up out of my mouth. God will vomit us up, but I don't want that. Father, right now, bring us up out of the ashes. Father, I declare this word is true. Father, right now, we must pray for the Middle East. We must pray for the land of Gaza, Egypt, Palestine, Israel. I'm praying for the warriors, all those that are in war. We are warring right now, but we don't war against the flesh, but we cast it down, all imagination. We pull down them rooted things. We're pulling them down, Lord. Lord, we're pulling down the flesh. We don't want to operate in the flesh. Father, we pull it down. We pull down all things that are exalted against the revelatory knowledge of Christ Jesus. Father God, you are the high priest. You are our revelation. You are our story. You are our improvement. Father God, I'm praying for anyone right now that needs a healing. I don't know what they need, Lord, but we came back today. We have to do more than just Sunday. Lord, we got to do it 7 days. We must do it 7. We must do it 7. He says 7. God says, can you worship me 7 days a week? I told you this is going to be organic. I'm almost done. I'm turning it up. I'm going all the way up. God says he needs us to worship him 365. He says you go to work outside of holidays 365. You punch the clock. God says this is not a clock. He says, I need my people on the wall, the wailing, weeping wall. I hear Jonah. He says, do not run like Jonah, because I'll swallow you up and spit you back out. But he says, I need you to go to Nineveh. God says right now, the report is this. I need my people to go to Nineveh. You may not think they're worth it, but were you worth it? I cleaned you off. Don't think that you're better than them. You're all in this together. But God says, I need you to go to Nineveh. Go to Nineveh and speak the word of the Lord. God says, I'm getting ready to repair the ancient ruins. When you believe that I can, he is supernaturally revoking anything. He's going to revoke that permit that you law. He says, I'm revoking it and I'm putting in your pocket a new story. Jesus, he says, be made well. He's healing us. It's in his fire. It's in his water. That's what he told the woman at the well. He told her, you had multiple husbands, but the man that you live with now is not your husband. She said, oh, you must be a prophet. He said, no, I am the Lord. Hi, I'm the Lord. He can do a story for you. She left her water pot. She was the first evangelist in the Middle East. It says that she ran out. She didn't run out of her clothes, but she ran fast, left the water pot at Jacob's well. What are you saying, prophet? I'm saying when God gets a hold of you, he'll change your life. He will change it tonight. He'll change it right now. I came to tell you on this Monday, the recording is this. We're winners in Christ Jesus. We can be alone, but we're never alone because he's always right next to you. And when he's not, he's on the phone. He does not need internet. He just wants us to cry out and say, Abba, Abba, God, help me. Ah, help me.
He's the Alpha and Omega. Tibetibo Shata Shizu. Habakashibo Namashate. Hiddu Shiba Kasha Pare Shitabo. Hadidu Shida. Hiddu Yashaya. Hiddu Mashaya. 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 Hiddu His revelation, his revelation. Ooh. It's in his revelation. It's in his revelation of his son. It's in his revelation of his son. Revelation. Revelation, 22 chapters, his revelation of his son, his revelation of his son, his revelation, his revelation.
Whatever you need, it's in Jesus.
His revelation, his revelation. Revelation, it's revelation.
He's gonna restore some, and some will be lost, but he's gonna restore some back into that tree, that wild olive tree. It's wild because they did not want to receive him, but we didn't want to either. Receive him, receive him, receive him. Receive him. Receive the Christ. Receive the kingdom of our Christ. Receive it, receive it, receive it. Receive it.
Will you believe it? Ooh, receive it. Oh, my kingdom.
From the Church Without Judgment, we love you. It's not by might, it's not by power, but it's by my Spirit. It's by my Spirit. By my Spirit, says the Lord. Thank you for that first and not last shop talk with worship from the Church Without Judgment. We love you. For the Word.